Good morning, student. Today we'll start with we'll continue with capital structure and we'll do working capital. Now what is working capital? Working capital is the capital which is required for to meet day-to-day expenses. It's a maximum limit of working capital is 1 year. Working capital is the difference between current assets and current liabilities. Now current assets are usually more liquid but contribute less to profit than as compared to fixed assets. These assets are expected to get converted into cash or cash equivalent within a period of 1 year. These provide liquidity to the business. Now, whereas current liabilities are those payment obligations which are due for payment within 1 year. Some part of current assets is usually financed through short-term sources, that is current liability. The rest is financed through long-term sources and is called net working capital. Now factors affecting, yesterday we did about factor affecting fixed capital, now factor affecting working capital. First is your nature of business. If the nature of business influences working capital requirement. If the business is trading, then we need less working capital as compared to a manufacturing business. Because in manufacturing business, we have to maintain finished goods stock, we have to maintain working capital, we have work in progress, we have to maintain raw material, we have to give wages. But this is not the case with trading. Now, scale of operation. For organization which operate on high scale of operation, the counter inventory, debtors and receivable required is generally high. Such organization therefore require a large amount of working capital as compared to organization which at lower scale. Like for cycling industry, it will be less as compared to car industry. Now business cycle. Now business cycle includes boom, recession, deflation. Now in case of boom, when there is demand for a product is more, like take an example during Diwali season, cracker, demand for cracker is more. During wedding season, demand for jewelry is more. So at that time, more working capital is required as compared to recession. Like today, the demand for jewelry is less. Why? Because of Corona. Now they will need less working capital as compared when there is a boom. Now seasonal factor also apply. Some goods they are manufactured throughout the year, but they are consumed during a particular period of time. So more working capital is required. And some products are consumed during a year, but only during a particular period they are manufactured. So more working capital. So if a firm operating in goods and services having seasonal fluctuation in demand, then working capital requirement will also fluctuate. This goes with your cotton clothes, woolen clothes. Now credit allowed. Now if the firm, if competition is there and credit firm has a policy of giving credit, now then more working capital is required. Different firm allow different credit terms to their customer, which depend upon the level of competition that a firm faces as well as the credit worthiness of their client. A liberal credit policy results in higher amount of debtors, increasing the requirement of working capital. Now credit avail. If you are allowing a credit, you will avail a credit also. This depends on your credit worthiness. If more suppliers are there and they are ready to give more credit, then less working capital is required. Now availability of raw materials. Some raw materials they are available during a particular period of time, and some are available throughout the year. Now for during a particular, if raw material is needed or is there for only a particular period, then more working capital is required. Like take an example, if you are in a silk industry, then your sales cocoon is available only during a particular period of time, so you need more raw material. So you need more working capital. Now operating efficiency. Firm manage their operations with varied degree of efficiency. For example, a firm managing its raw material efficiently may be able to manage with a smaller balance, which will result in high inventory turnover ratio. Similarly, a better trade receivable turnover ratio may be achieved reducing the amount of tied up in receivables. Now better sales efforts may reduce the average time for which finished goods inventory is held, resulting in lower requirement of working capital. Now, next is your growth prospect. If growth prospects are there, in near future, more potential is there for growth, then more working capital is required as compared to those with the stagnant prospects. Now, level of competition. Higher level of competitiveness may necessitate larger stock of finished goods to meet urgent orders from customers, which result in more working capital required. Let's take an example. 30 years back, only Bajaj was there, Premier Padni was there, Mazda was there. So they had a monopoly in the economy. So what in their industry? So what have used to happen? People used to deposit first their money, then they used to supply. Now this is not the case. Now they have to maintain a raw material, they have to maintain a stock because competition is high. Now inflation. If there is a price rise and the cost of raw material and labor also rise, it will result in increase in working capital requirement. Thank you.